I define undergraduate research as a process by which we start to engage students into the ways of thinking of a discipline and an entry into an experience beyond those that are structured through our traditional curricula.
I define undergraduate research as an undergraduate student working closely with a faculty member to produce something that engages the student in an intellectual conversation beyond the classroom. And so that can take a variety of different forms and a variety of different mechanisms, but I think it's them producing something that gets them thinking about the material in a different way.
A scholarly endeavor undertaken by a mentor and a student that makes a novel contribution to a body of work. That includes inquiry as well as creative endeavors. So I really believe wholeheartedly that undergraduate research spans the gamut of scholarly approaches within the academy.
In my context, undergraduate research is about students contributing to knowledge. Now, that might be knowledge that's new to them as a student, but in most instances, it's new knowledge in terms of they've collected data from a new source or using a new methodology and analysed that and come up with something that's different. I think undergraduate research, the definitions can be quite fuzzy and broad, and so in the first year of an undergraduate degree, it might mean students thinking about questions and going and reading the literature and coming up with a new idea that's something that's advanced their knowledge and understanding. And there's the potential for them to contribute to new knowledge at that stage, but it's not necessarily going to happen. But I still think they're engaged in research and they are undergraduates. But hopefully by the end of their third year in a British context, so you might say during a capstone project or something like that, students are genuinely contributing something new. So they wouldn't just be engaging with literature, they would be engaging with data that they've generated themselves, analysing that and disseminating that in some way. In the UK, they often do that through, we call it a dissertation or a thesis, about 10,000 words. But they can also do that through undergraduate research conferences, through journal articles dedicated for undergraduate researchers to publish in, and that kind of activity. So all of that I would call undergraduate research.
I define undergraduate research usually according to what the Council on Undergraduate Research came to, because I was part of those discussions some years ago, which is that this is intellectual activity conducted by an undergraduate student with faculty mentoring, which is crucial, that leads to the creation or the discovery of knowledge. So it can be traditional research, but it also could be creative scholarship, whatever scholars do in the field at an undergraduate level.
I think for me, when I think of undergraduate research, it's the opportunity for students to take their classroom and field interests and engage them in a very practical manner. So it's not necessarily about a specific research process, but it's about the process of putting what you're learning into practice and seeing where that takes you.
The definition of undergraduate research is a really interesting one. So a lot of places define undergraduate research using the Council for Undergraduate Research definition, which is students involved in the projects related to the creation of new knowledge. I personally find that actually too narrow a definition. So I tend to actually use and have published using a broader definition of undergraduate research and inquiry. So I usually add the "and inquiry" onto the end of the definition, or onto the end of the phrase. And I use Angela Brew and David Bowd's work from 1995, where they talked about the undergraduate research being students learning through research processes, whether they're learning something that's what they called commonly known, so it's known to experts in the discipline, but it's new to the students. Commonly unknown, meaning it's expert to just a couple specialists in a field, but is unknown to even to their peers and their colleagues, and new to the students, or totally unknown, which is new knowledge. So I tend to use a kind of a broader definition that spans that spectrum of the commonly known to the totally unknown.
I define undergraduate research as a process in which students, sometimes by themselves, sometimes in collaboration with a faculty, answer the question of their interests in while using scientific methods. I would like to add to that that there, besides undergraduate research, there is a portion of creative activities, which also involves same procedures, minus probably scientific methods, but more of creative processes.
I think there's an element of kind of mentoring and intellectual capacity building that really goes into an experience like that. And I think it ultimately, really for all the disciplines, is about a generation of knowledge in whatever particular field of study that you're coming from. So it's about formulating a particular question or a big question that you don't know the answer to, and perhaps nobody does, and trying to figure out a plan to help you explain that or come to an answer with that particular question. So I think it's at heart, I think it's a sort of a remarkable academic pursuit for students to be involved in the generation of knowledge.